English Chapter 2 Buka Learns a Lesson. Good morning, children. Today we are going to listen to a story about Buka, who is a naughty elephant and do not listen to his elders and troubles the little animals in the jungle. First, we'll read out the story. Remember, you are all big animals. The older elephant warned the junior. When lying down on the ground, you must watch out for snails. See that you don't crush them under your weight. It is the snail that tells you when the flood water enters the forest. Check if there are baby squirrels in the hollows of the trees when you shake the branches of the trees to pick the fruit. Then these animals will be the first ones to give you the news of any danger. The squirrel will bring out the news of an approaching forest fire. Here, the older elephants are instructing the juniors how they have to behave with the other animals. The older elephants informs the younger ones that while lying on the ground, you must watch out for snails so that they don't get crushed under their weight, because snails are the ones who will inform them about the flood water entering the forest. The older elephants also informs the juniors that they have to check out for the baby squirrels if there is any in the hollow of the trees, because while shaking the branches of the trees, they might get hurt. The squirrels are the one who brings the news of an approaching forest fire. The older elephants do not only teach young elephants how to live in harmony with others, but also teach them how to live in harmony among their own kind. When you get news of good food, the elder tells the junior, you must not eat alone. You must send a message to others, and if any members of the herd face danger, everyone must rush to help. You should always remember, however big you are, you might face danger if you are alone. The young elephants listen to their elders with rapt attention. The older elephants of the herd are teaching the young elephants not only to live in harmony with others, but also among themselves. The older elephants of the herd teaches the small elephants that when they get the news of a good food, they must not have it alone. They must inform their other members of the herd so they can share the food with others. They also teach the small ones that if any member of the herd faces any danger, everyone must rush to help, because however big you are, you might face danger if you are alone. All the small elephants listen to that instructions very keenly, but Buka does not listen to all this. Only Buka does not like to listen to all this. Buka knows that one day he will become the leader of the herd. He will become huge and have those big tusks. Everyone in the jungle will be afraid of him. So Buka doesn't bother to make friends with those small creatures at all. Am I a fool that I will share any good food that I find? Thinks Buka. In fact, I should be eating all that good food, shouldn't I? I have to grow up quickly. After all, I have to become the leader one day. So Buka breaks off flowers and also branches with nests. Every young elephants are listening keenly to the instructions given by the elders. Only Buka does not like to listen to all this, because he believes that as he will grow up, he will become the leader of the herd. So there is no need of him to make friendship with this small creature. As well as he feels it is foolishness to share his food with the others, because it is his right to have all the good food, because he is going to become the leader of the herd one day. So Buka breaks up all the branches and flowers with the nest. He crushes snails underfoot. He squeezes water in rabbit's hole with his trunk. All the animals were tired of his mischief. One day they complain to the leader of the elephant herd. Please do something, they tell the leader. Buka is becoming very naughty. The leader hears them out and realizes that naughty Buka needs to be taught a lesson. That night, like always, Buka goes to sleep next to his mother's warm side. But in the morning, he wakes up surprised. He finds himself alone to the bank of the small pool. There is simply no one. Buka, becoming very naughty, he crushes snail underfoot, pours the water in the rabbit hole with his trunk. All the animals were tired with his mischief. So one day, all the animals of the jungle decide to go to the elephant, leader of the elephant herd, and complain him about the Buka's mischief. They went to them and complained, Buka is becoming very naughty. The leader hears them and realizes then, yes, that Bukka needs to be taught to a lesson. So, to teach him a lesson, that night when Bukka goes to sleep to his mother's side, in the next morning when he wakes up, he is surprised because there is no one by his side. He was left alone. He wakes up and sees here and there. Bukka jumps up and searches nearer the pool. No, there is no sign of the elephant herd. He lifts his trunk to catch the smell floating in the breeze. No luck there. Bukka feels frightened. He starts crying. What will happen now? Where will he find his parents in such a huge and dense forest? Poor Bukka turns to the birds, animals and insects in the forest for help. But they all turn away. The squirrel says, have you forgotten how you shook the branches and made us fall? The rabbit's mother says, don't you remember how you poured water down your hole? Bukka, the next morning when Bukka finds that no one is there, he jumps up and searches near the pool, but he doesn't find anyone of the elephant herd. So what he does is he lifts his trunk in the air to catch the smell of his friends. But no luck, Bukka feels frightened, he gets scared. So he starts crying. For help, he runs to the other birds and animals. But they all turn away. They don't help him. The squirrel says to Bukka, have you forgotten how you shook the branches and made the fall? The rabbit's mother also reminds him about the water poured by him in the holes. We nearly died. We see how it feels. Serves you right. Or everyone denies to help Bukka, because Bukka has harassed each and every animal in the forest. The butterflies too refuse to help him. Bukka starts crying because there is no one, and then he falls asleep crying beside the pool. Next day when he wakes up, he finds himself sleeping right in the middle of his herd, next to his mother's warm belly. Was that a dream? Bukka thinks to himself. After that day, no complaints about Bukka ever again. We nearly died. The squirrels said that. Rabbit said that they had been harassed by this elephant. So they refused to help Bukka. Even butterflies refused to help Bukka. So without the help of any animals, Bukka gets scared because he is not able to find out his family and other members of the herd. So Bukka starts crying. After crying, he falls asleep beside the pool. Next day when he wakes up, he finds himself right in the middle of the herd, next to his mother's warm belly. When he wakes up, he feels that whether it was a dream or it was a true incident. But after that day, Bukka realizes that no other animals should be harassed or any mischief should be done so that anyone gets any problem. So Bukka never did any mischief, and from that day onwards, no complaints about Bukka came ever again. So children, what did you learn from this story? We should never harass anyone else or should not do any mischief that caused harm to anyone else, because we need everyone in our life in one or the another way. So be generous and be happy.